Given the CMOS circuit with pull down shown here, we can generate the corresponding function that the CMOS circuit represents, which is not F equals A or B ANDed with C or D. So F equals A or B ANDed with C or D, the whole thing negated. This function can be expressed as a truth table which describes the output that the function produces for any set of inputs. All of the possible input combinations are enumerated, and then the value of F is specified for each of those combinations. For this function F, for example, if A equals 0, B equals 0, C equals 0, and D equals 0, then A or B and C equals 0, that ORed with D equals 0, and finally the entire thing is negated, so F equals 1. For A equals 0, B equals 0, C equals 0, and D equals 1, A or B ANDed with C equals 0, ORed with D equals 1 gives us 1, and the whole thing negated is F equals 0. In the same way, we can complete the rest of the truth table, and we get 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. Given a truth table, one can be asked if the function F that this truth table defines can be implemented using a single CMOS gate. To figure that out, we first convert the truth table to a logical equation for F. Given this truth table, the function F can be expressed as a sum of products by listing all terms that make F equals 1 and ORing them together. For this truth table, F equals not A, not B, not C, or not A, B, not C, or A, not B, not C. In order to determine if this function can be implemented as a single CMOS circuit, the function F needs to be manipulated through logic simplifications in order to see if not F can be written as a function of just the inputs A, B, and C without any negations of those inputs, together with ANDs and ORs. We start with our function for F. Factoring out not C, that equals not C ANDed with not A not B or not A B or A not B. Rearranging the terms and repeating the first one continues to produce the same function. So F equals not C ANDed with not A not B or A not B or not A B or not A not B. Noting that AX ORed with not AX equals X, this reduces to F equals not C ANDed with not B or not A. We're almost there. We now want to convert F to not F by negating the entire thing. So not F equals not of not C ANDed with not B or not A. To simplify this, we make use of De Morgan's law, which states that not of A and B equals not A or not B, and that not of A or B equals not A and not B. So not F equals C or not of not B or not A, and finally not F equals C or B and A. Now that we have found that not F equals C or BA, we know that F can be implemented as a single CMOS gate because we were able to express not F as a function that consists purely of our non-negated inputs A, B, and C together with ANDs and ORs. The pull-down for the circuit would basically implement not F, so it would be series AB in parallel with C. The pull-up would be the inverse of that, which is parallel AB in series with C.